Hello everyone. Today I'm here to speak about a very important process called as ICSI. ICSI or intracytoplasmic sperm injection, as the name tells you, is a process in which we actually take hold of just one egg and one sperm. And once we've stabilized it under a microscope, we actually inject the sperm inside that single egg. So one sperm is actually put inside the big egg so that fertilization happens. Now fertilization basically means the mixing of the egg and the sperm so that the embryo is formed. Now this is a specialized form of IVF, a step further where we are doubly ensuring that yes, fertilization happens to a maximum extent, which actually might not happen in some patients, more so in males where the sperm count is very low. So if you have a patient who has a very low count, as low as 1 million motile sperms, there we might opt for something called as ICSI, even lower than that. Ideally, according to our books, we just need one good motile sperm which looks healthier under the big microscope. That sperm can be picked up and put inside the egg to create a new life. It is actually miraculous. So when we talk of this procedure, we can actually do this procedure also in patients who have recurrent fertilization failures. In a normal IVF, what we usually do is we put the eggs and sperms in one petri dish, in one small plastic dish, right? In that petri dish, the sperms go and actually attach themselves to the egg on their own. But if there is a fertilization failure, that is, if the eggs and the sperms are not able to meet together to form a proper, good, healthy embryo, we might need to do something called as ICSI or intracytoplasmic sperm injection under a big microscope. Whenever there are motility issues with the sperms, now sperms, not only the count is important, but also the motility, because normally in a normal patient, the sperms will travel up from the vagina to the fallopian tubes to fertilize, to form a good healthy embryo. So motility of sperms is very, very important for a normal pregnancy to happen. But if there are problems, then again ICSI is the answer for them. When we talk of patients having a little aged eggs, that is, once the maternal age is increasing, the number of eggs are decreasing, they start having a little more thicker outer layer, which is called as a thick zona pellucida. In such scenarios, again, ICSI could be the procedure of choice. Overall, if you look at the success of pregnancy, yes, there is a slight improvement over and above a normal IVF if we are using ICSI as a methodology. Thank you.